All right, guys, so today I'm going to show you how we can actually create a isometric grid in Illustrator. But before I continue on how we can actually create one, I just got to give you a little understanding what is isometric or isometric art. An isometric art is a drawing or illustration style that makes two-dimensional figures appear three-dimensional. You might ask, what in the world I'm talking about here? So what happens is, let's say, for example, if you're the viewer, and if you're inside an elevator and you're looking down on the corner of an elevator, so basically you're seeing a perspective that has almost like three points. You have a top view, a side view, and a front view. Basically, that kind of makes it an isometric. Now, it's similar to a perspective view, but basically what it is, the difference between them is it gives you that illusion like three-dimensional design, but isometric drawing doesn't have a vanishing point. That's the difference between perspective and isometric. That means that they appear exactly the same no matter how you place them on a canvas or wherever the viewer stands. Just to kind of give you an idea, these are some basic elements that I did. Using the isometric grid. So, you know, kind of doing like a little car, a little truck, and a little rhino as well. So you can be creative on how you can actually develop all these kind of objects and so on. Now, I'm using Illustrator here, and I created multiple canvases to kind of create this presentation. Now, I have this canvas that I created. And this canvas, basically, my dimensions are 2,500 by 2,000. Now, it all depends what you're trying to achieve or create. The size of the grid does matter. Just to kind of give you some clues, the smaller the grid is, the more detail you can apply to an object, okay? So, my thing, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to create a basic grid here. And I already have my grid open up here, but if you cannot find it, it's inside the line segment tool. And right in there, you're going to find the rectangular grid. Now, remember, the size of my document is 2,500 by 2,000. So I'm going to click on my artboard, and I have a width of 2,500 by 2,500. I just made it a nice square size. That way makes my math a little bit simpler. So one of the things I want to do is I want to create my horizontal dividers 100 by 100, so 100 pixels or so, right? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to hit OK. And now I got this nice grid in my scene. And I just want to align it to the center of this canvas, okay? So I'm just using my alignment tool on the top. And basically what I'm going to do here, I'm going to do a couple of things. Excuse me. I'm going to actually do some changes. I'm going to do some transformation. I'm going to scale it. And then I'm going to change, excuse me, the direction and the angles of this grid. So one of the things I'm going to do is I'm going to go under Object. And I'm going to go under Transform, and in there you're going to find the scale. Within the scale, by default, you have the uniform selection that allows you to scale proportional from top to bottom or left and right. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to check the non-uniform here. And what I want to do is I want to distort a little bit my perfect square. And the number that I'm going to use is going to be 86.602. And if you hit your preview, you're going to notice what it does. It's going to skews it. It kind of makes it shorter, excuse me, from top to bottom. And once I do that, I'm going to hit OK. Then still with my grid selection selected, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to Object, Transform, and I'm going to go to Shear. When the shear window pops up, make sure that your horizontal axis is selected, and I'm going to make this a 30 degrees on the angle, And if you preview this, you're going to notice it kind of creates this nice little shear. And I'm going to hit OK. One last step is we need to rotate this 30 degrees negative, and we're going to go to Object, Transform, Rotate, and I'm going to do negative 30. I'm going to hit OK. Now you notice that basically we have created our isometric grid. What I like to do is I want to make sure that I group it. And now I have this nice isometric, and if you have a document that you want to copy it to, I always recommend to kind of have an original saved somewhere as a template. That way you can bring it in to other files and work from there. All right. So one of the things I'm going to do is I'm going to copy it. Just make a copy of it. And let's say, for example, I have a new document. So I'm going to lock this on my space right here by selecting them and going to Edit, Object. I'm going to select it as Object. I did the shortcut Command 2 or Control 2 if you're using PC. So if you go to Object and you say Lock Selection, Control 2, I'm using a PC. It's going to give you that. It's going to lock that selection. Okay, that way it doesn't get picked. Now I have a different artboard here. Let's say, for example, you open up a new document and you have a different artboard. I'm going to paste that in the front. Control F to place it right in the front. So one of the things I'm going to do, I'm going to hold my Shift and Alt on my keyboard, and I'm going to scale it down just to kind of fit. Remember, the smaller I make it, the more detail I can apply to my object. The bigger, you have more workspace to do. You have more space to kind of work with your area. You know what? Let's leave it a little bit bigger. That's fine. Now, one of the cool features that I'm going to use here, I like to use my guidelines. That way I can get rid of all those lines that I just created with that grid. And the way you do that, you go make sure your grid is selected, and you're going to go under View, you're going to go Guides, and Make. And now you notice that now it created a bunch of guidelines. Now you have this nice little grid that, you know, you made it with guidelines. Let me lock this little box that I created. So now you have a nice isometric grid that you can actually start creating and playing around with some basic shapes and objects. So just to kind of give you an idea how this works, I'm not going to get into details on creating elements, but just to kind of give you an idea how this works, I'm going to make another video to show you how you can actually create shapes and objects and so on. So down here, I'm just going to zoom in, and let's say, for example, I want to create a box, like a nice isometric box. And you know what? Let me use some nice bright colors here. So I'm going to grab my pen tool, so hitting the letter P, the shortcut, or you can just come over here, select the pen tool. The key here, you got to make sure that you're always snapping on your guides, on those points that meet each other. So I'm going to click right in there. Now, whenever you're creating your vertical line, they always stay straight. They don't turn, they don't do anything, they stay straight. Only the ones that they turn are the ones going from almost like top to bottom and so on, right? So in that angle. So from here, I'm just gonna click on that point, hold my Shift key so I can create a nice straight line, and I'm gonna count 1, 2, click. I'm gonna, now you see how it didn't snap? I've got to make sure that I snap on that. It's very important to kind of keep it nice and straight. I'm going to hold my Shift key just to kind of go up. I'm going to close this box right now. I'm going to zoom in because I feel that I didn't do a good job snapping it to it. I'm going to select the letter A to select my direct selection tool. I'm going to click and make sure that I snap it right into that line, and the same thing here. This is the key right here, guys. You gotta make sure that everything is lined up properly, okay? If this part right here at the beginning, you don't get it right, whatever you're developing is going to be off. All right. So let's say, for example, now I have this box right here. And now I'm going to create a top of this box. So let's say, for example, I grab my pen tool again. I'm going to come from this area. Let's say I want it to be the same amount of squares, just to make something very simple. Let's change the color to something a little bit lighter. Let's say, for example, the light is hitting on the top. Now we got this little guy going. And the same thing, one, two boxes. Make sure I snap it. For some reason, this guy doesn't want to snap to my guy here. That's fine. I will snap it manually now. There we go. Letter I. I is for the eyedropper. You just want to make it darker so you can see the 4 points here. So now you have the 3 points, right? So almost. And this is how you create an isometric cube. So you have a side or a front view, and then you have a top view as well. Now, some of the cool things that you can do is that you can always, if you have make a perfect shape within your isometric grid, one of the cool things is I can group this guy and I can go to edit, copy, edit, base in front, and I can scale down, make it smaller, and I can bring this guy up, and I'm just holding my shift key, and it should automatically fit. Everything should fit properly because my grid is going the right way. So I'm going to copy, paste in front, scale it down, and move it up. And you notice how it fits nice and perfectly with my isometric. Now I can create more custom shapes and so on with these tools and this nice little grid. But for right now, I'm going to leave it here, and I'm going to make some other videos on how you can actually create some more detail and more advanced shape that can help you develop your content using isometric grid. So remember, start developing your isometric grid, copy it to a new document, create a guidelines, and so on. So I hope this was helpful to you guys, and I see you next time. Thank you.